Psalms 41, starting at the 10th verse. And the word of the Lord, which is blessed and sanctified, begins to read as thus. But thou, O Lord, be merciful unto me, and raise me up, that I may requite them. Verse 11, by this I know that thou favorest me, because my enemies doeth not triumph over me. And as for me, thou upholdest me in my integrity, and settest me before thy face forever. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, from everlasting to everlasting. Amen and amen. And the word of the Lord is blessed. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you tremendously for what you have done. We honor you for what you're preparing to do. We celebrate you for this day, for this is the day, Lord, you've made. We're going to rejoice and be glad in it. We thank you, Lord God, that as it stands on this day and for the days moving forward throughout the duration of our lives, no weapon which is formed against us shall prosper. We thank you that every tongue that shall rise up against us shall be condemned. We thank you right now in the name of Jesus that your anointing that goes before us that began to break down and destroy the very yokes that the enemy has put upon the people. Lord God, we thank you for the authority of your word, because at your authority of your word, you bring change and deliverance. Through your word, you bring manifestation and clarity. Through your word, you bring uplifting and security. Through your word, Lord God, we stand on your word and the principles of your word. Not our will, Lord God, but thine will be done in the name of Jesus. For we call on the name that's above every name. Jesus is his name. And thank you, Lord God, as we hear your name, because through your name, you're calling people back to repentance. Through your name, you're calling back people back to a level of humility. Through your name, Lord God, you're calling people back to being a level of integrity. Through your word, Lord God, so it is at your name we declare your glory here in the earth realm. It is at your name, Lord God, we declare your power in the earth realm. It is at your name, Lord God, we declare all that you have us to have and to receive. It is at your name we can say to let the sick, Lord God, say that I'm healed. And at your name, Lord God, we said, let the blind say that I can see. And at your name, Lord God, we can declare your glory in this earth realm. And Lord, we thank you. Hey, we thank you. We thank you, Lord God. And we give you glory. And we give you honor. And we give you praise. And it is so done. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And amen. To God be the glory. You may be seated in Jesus' name. Amen. Our topic of discussion will be lifted from the 11th verse. And the word of the Lord, which is blessed and sanctified, once again declares the 11th verse, which says, by this I know that thou favorest me, because mine enemies doeth not triumph over me. Do me one favor, look at your neighbor, say, neighbor. Oh, come on, you got to say it with some conviction and authority. Say, neighbor, I know that's right. This is one of those words, Lord God, that you have to see it for what it is and identify the power that's wrapped in the word. Amen. Herein we, this topic, I know that's right. Amen. When we as a people hear this kind of topical statement, I know that's right, it puts us in the mindset that this topical statement is from a response to a truthful statement. It's like a confirmation to what has now hit your ear gate and is now manifested in your conviction to say, I know that's right. When the word of God is being delivered and there is a confirmation to some things that you have been praying for that now comes to a level to become manifested, I want you to know and understand it's like a leap in your spirit to say, I know that's right. When you hear the spoken word, there is, or should I say, there used to be a time, Brother Byron used to say back in the old school church, amen, when you heard something, your response would be, amen. Amen. But you have to understand, I learned years ago, be careful what you say amen to. Amen. Because it's like writing a blank check, signing your name to a blank check. Everything doesn't deserve an amen. I got to call it for what it is. Amen. You must know what you're saying amen to. Amen. And who you're saying amen to. Amen. Because everybody is talking good. That doesn't mean that they're living good. Amen. That doesn't mean that they're really serving the way they should be serving. That's not my call. Amen. That's between you and the Lord. But nevertheless, amen. I say amen because I'm confirming God's word. I can say amen because I've gone through hell and back. So I can say some amen to some stuff that you can't say amen to. Amen. You can say some amen to some stuff that you've been through that I have not been through. When you have lived a little while and you have gone through some stuff and you've gone through some people and people have gone through you, amen, and some left good impression, some left not so good impression. When you hear the word of the Lord say, be not weary in your well-doing, for you shall reap in due season, your response is, I know that's right. Amen. Because all the stuff that I've gone through, all the stuff that you've gone through, all the stuff that you're going through, please know and recognize that all that is happening because it's happening for the development of your growth. These things are necessary for your growth. We don't like the process. No one likes the process, but the process is necessary for your growth. It's necessary for your development. It's necessary for you to begin to move forward to the next level of your destiny. I want you to know here the story of this chapter opens up with David. When David was on his sickbed and his enemies had hoped that it was nothing trivial, they wanted something to be serious. You got to be ever so mindful of people that you got around you, because they laugh at your jokes, because they smile in your face, because they wave a handkerchief when you say something that's good. That doesn't mean they support you. That doesn't mean they got your best interest at heart, amen, because you're in a day and time where a lot of things are going on and people got underhidden agendas and underhidden motives in order to push forward their plan. But I'm so grateful, as we learned on Tuesday, on Wednesday night, about discernment. You got to have discernment when you're interfering, when you're interacting with other saints of the Most High God. You got to have discernment when you're functioning with people that's not in the Church of the Living God, because it's not the person, it's the spirit in the person, and you got to see it for what it is. Amen. If it walks like a duck and quacks like a dog, duck, amen, and waddles like a duck, that doesn't mean it's an alligator. You got to stop. Listen, betrayal will always leave clues. And sometimes people are happening right in front of your face, and sometimes things are happening right in front of your face, and situations are happening in front of your face, but you choose not to acknowledge it for what it is. But 2017, beloved, you got to open your eyes and see, because the thief comes to kill and to steal and to destroy. But God said, I've come that you may have life and have life more. I just want to make sure you're with me. Amen. Please know and understand. I don't want you to, please know. And don't let your enemies find out that you were down for a moment due to circumstances that's beyond your control. The moment your enemy get wind that you're down, amen. It's just so funny. When your enemy see that you're down, that's the time they want to kick at you. That's the time they want to get at you. That's the time they want to really talk about you. See, it was nothing to them anyway. Isn't that right, Mecca? Amen. It was nothing to them anyway. Amen. I always felt that they were just playing games. Amen. But you got to be careful how you treat me in this season. Amen. Because in everything there's a time and there's a season. Amen. I'm not perfect. Every now and then I got a moment. But you got to be careful how you treat me when I'm in my moment. Because, amen, I'm not going to be here always. I'm only here just for the moment. Amen. But when I get out of this moment, amen, everybody that did what they did at the time that they did it, trust me, it is duly noted in heaven. For the Lord said, vengeance is mine, and whatever is right, I will pay. I don't have to fight this battle, because the battle doesn't belong to me. The battle belongs to God. And the best way in order to go forth in this battle, when all the hell is going on around you, you got to lift your hands up and give God praise. Amen. Because your praise is your weapon. Because your enemy wants you to be sitting down without a praise. Your enemy wants you to be sitting down without a hallelujah. The enemy wants you to be sitting down looking like doom and gloom has knocked on your door. But you got to tell the devil, you are a lying wonder. I don't care what you did yesterday. My yesterday does not define my today as I'm moving in my tomorrow. Because morning by morning, new mercies I'm able to see. Because great is the Lord's faithfulness unto me. I don't know who I'm talking to this morning, but you better get up and let the devil know what you did yesterday has no effect on my today as I'm moving into my tomorrow. Somebody need to holler, I know that's right. Please know, amen, that you will find that your enemies and the enemies of your enemies will join forces to sing your demise. Have you ever had that situation where you had one person that didn't like you on one side and another person didn't like you on another side, and the moment they got wind that you were now the target, they now come together to sit there and they now come to your funeral? But you got to tell the devil is a liar. You better put up your black dress. I shall live and not die. Whatever you declare, it doesn't work on me. So you better be careful, first of all, where you put your mouth, because I am a child of God. For the Bible has declared it's better that you put a millstone around your neck and tie it and throw yourself into the depths of the sea than to offend the least one of mine. Because when you defend the least one of the children of the Most High God, you are now offending God Almighty. God said, I am I, oh God. I am that I am. You got to let your enemy know enough is enough. 2017, you better not run from near another enemy. You better not run from near another enemy. 2017 is your year. If you didn't get no courage, brother, my sister, you better get some courage. 2017, you better come out swinging. Lord, I'm about to shut up the Lord. You better come out swinging in 2017, because enough is enough. You took it not long enough. You bear with it long enough. You stomached it long enough. You carried it long enough. This is your year of your breakthrough. This is your year of your deliverance. This is your year of turnaround. This is your year. Get up and fight. Hey, hey, hey. You better get up and fight, because if you don't fight, the what right will belong to you. Somebody needs a holler. I know that's right. 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 Do we want favor, say neighbor? Find somebody, say neighbor. I may be down now, but I'm not out. Long as I got breath in my body, baby, I'm getting up. I may have had a moment, but I'm getting right back up. Yeah, I may have been knocked down, but I'm getting right back up. You don't know what the hell, you don't know what the hell you've done. Amen. Messing with me, hell now is on. You try to kill me, but I want you to know it didn't work. You try to silence me, but I want you to know it didn't work. You try to lock me up, I want you to know it didn't work. Because greater is he that's within me than he that's in the world. You got to let the devil know enough is enough. See, you must use the word of God at your defense.
When all else fails, only the word is going to stand. If you want to whip your enemy, you better use the word. Because the enemy's not fighting fair. And you're trying to fight the enemy on his ground. You're already lost because you're fighting on his ground. Get off of his ground and get on the Lord's ground. Hallelujah, the ground that you stand on is holy ground. Anything that's not of God has got to get off the ground. Either get right or get off the ground. See, the enemy knows your strategy. I know you get up to pray every morning, and you pray at the same time every morning. You get on the phone with your prayer partners every week. I know exactly what time. So I can fix it to drive you crazy till you get there. But you better realize, tell the devil, you may think you're going to drive me crazy. Let the God that answers by fire, let him be God. You do what you got to do on your side, but ask of me, let me do what I'm going to do on my side. You think you shut me up? All the hell that I've been through, you talk about shut me up? All the pain that I've been through, you talk about shut me up? All the lies that were told on me, you think you're going to shut me up? All the scandalization that came against me, you think you're going to shut me up? All those wannabes that came at me, you think you're going to shut me up? You, baby, you better bring it. You better bring it. But trust me, as you bring it, I'm bringing my also, let the God that's an answer by fire, let him be God. Enough is enough, and I know that's right. You better realize that what's in me is greater than what the devil can even bring your way. If I get on my knees to pray, God will hear me. If I begin to cry, God will hear me. If I lift my hands, God will hear me, and I know that is. No. See, the problem that you're having, you have allowed the devil to hypnotize you to make you think that you are less than who you are. So now you got controlling spirits around you. Yes, I'm going this morning. You got controlling spirits around you. You have lost the essence of who you are. You don't smile like you used to smile. You don't rejoice like you because you're afraid that the person that's controlling you will get upset. But the devil is a lying wonder. I shall not die. I shall live and declare the glory of the Lord. If you don't like it, that's between you and your maker. Answer me in my house. We shall and we will bless the Lord. We will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. Hallelujah. You must have lost your mind. You thought you were going to control. You must have lost your mind to allow that controlling spirit to cause you to lose you. And if you want to blame that mess on God, God said, I had nothing to do with it. is what you allowed to happen, that's what happened to you. But God said today is the day you can break free. You just got to open up your mouth, and if you want to be free, ask and it shall be given. Knock and the door shall be answered. Seek and ye shall find. God will give you just what you need. See, let me let you know how it is. Not only controlling spirits, you got seducing spirits. Spirits that will seduce you to try to win you over. We're in a day and time where people are being seduced. Amen. Because running around having an itching ear, they'd rather go hear a lie than to hear the truth. They'd rather go hear prosperity instead of get your life right and do it now. Get your life right. He will show you how. You got to understand we're in a day and time where people would rather hear about how my bank account is going to be filled instead of realizing what does it profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his soul. Is your soul worth $5? Is your soul worth $100,000? No, my soul is not for sale. See, David's enemies were already rejoicing amongst themselves that his illness was an undoubtedly terminal. People right now are planning your demise, saying that you'll never be nothing without me. You'll never go nowhere without me. You'll never be successful without me. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, that was a lie. After the Lord gets through with me, I shall come forth as pure gold. Please know, Steve Harvey said, don't trip. He ain't through with me yet. Y'all got to understand there's a problem. Amen. Because as there's a problem, God going to deal with that mess. And as God going to deal with that mess, God going to fix it that he deal with that mess. Amen. Because he's not through with you. So be careful. Be careful how you act when God is in the midst. You got to understand that there's royalty in your midst. You got to understand that there's sovereignty in your midst. You got to recognize, get your mind ready, because God can snatch your mind and you can walk out of here crippled and crazy. God can snatch your breath and you will lay out here on the altar and we'll be eulogizing you. Don't play with God. God will deal with your behind. You better recognize God is the spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. You got to get it right with. See, David's enemies were planning his funeral, failing to realize that it wasn't David. David had Jehovah Jireh, the Lord God that provides, Jehovah Rapha, Jehovah Nisi, Jehovah Tiskenu, Jehovah Shalom. He had all of the attributes of God that were supporting him. So as they talked about him, David didn't get in the corner and start crying like some of us. Why are they talking about me? Why are they getting at me? Why won't they support me? They're doing that because they're planning your funeral. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, put away that black garment. It's a waste of your time. Because I shall live and not die. You talk about living, you ain't seen nothing yet. You talk about living, you ain't seen nothing yet. All the hell that I've been through in 2016, 2015, 2014, 2013, 2012, 2011, 2010, 29, 28, 27, 26. all the hell that I've been through to get here now and die, the devil is a liar and wonder. I shall not.
See, you got to understand, every now and then you need to be jolted of how awesome you are in the eyes of the Lord. What is man that thou art mindful of him? The son of man that thou visitest him? For he's made us a little lower than the angels and crowned us with glory. Do you know who you are in the Lord? Because if you knew who you are in the Lord, whoever comes your way that's not right, either they got to come correct or don't come at all. It's time now. Yeah, I'm going to say a word that we don't hear in the church of the living God no more. Some people that may be viewing me thinking that I'm saying a profanity word. But this word needs to be rang out. Because we're lifting up everything but what needs to be lifted up. Oh, I can't get no help here. We're lifting up everything instead of what needs to be lifted up. And that word is repentance. I got to save some for this afternoon. But the word of God says we got to repent ye therefore that your sins may be blotted out. For there's a time of refreshing that's coming from the Lord. If you're not living right, you got to repent. And I was just talking with my wife on the way coming to church this morning. We hop on certain areas of sins. But then we dismiss all others. All unrighteousness is sin. Don't talk about some if you're not going to talk about all. See, we got to get back down to holiness preaching. I don't want to hear you moan and you groan. Give me a word that's going to keep me for the rest of the week. I don't want to hear a hymn and a hum. I need a word that I don't smack my boss when I go into work on Tuesday. I need a word that's going to tell me, be still and know that I am God. I need a word when I really want to take my kids and throw them up against a wall. Give me a word that will keep me. See, the problem that we're having, we're preaching to people's emotions instead of preaching to their souls. There's a problem. You got an attitude problem and you wonder what's wrong with everybody else. No, it's you. And as I close on this, please know, and I want you to understand that when you have a moment, take a look through the back door of your life to see where the Lord has brought you from. Because you may not have what you want to have right now, but what's coming is better than what's been. Somebody needed to holler. I know that's right. I know that's right. And as the Lord delivered David, the Lord wants to deliver you too. It's time now. Stop playing second fiddle to the devil. You have played second fiddle long enough. You're in first position. Do you know this? And I'll close with scripture. That if you get a loan, if you get a mortgage on a property, The bank don't want to see you got a loan with somebody else. Why? Because they want to be in first position. So if anything goes in a level of default, they're guaranteed to get paid first. And whoever is after that, they don't care as long as they get theirs first. That's how you got to be with your anointing. You're in first position. And whatever the Lord's going to pay, you want to make sure you're in first position to get paid. Everything else got to become second, but I got to make sure I get mine, because I've been through too much hell to sit here and not get mine. A lot of us, let's call it for what it is, a lot of us has been in this walk a long time, and we've seen some stuff. We've heard some stuff. We've even experienced some stuff. But out of all the hell we've been through, we still have our joy. We still got our praise. We still got our anointing. We still have our breakthrough. Please know and understand, no matter how you look at it from this day and move it forward, the devil is and always will be a liar. There's no truth in him. I close on this. For Psalms 121, first verse, you've now got to change your attitude. If you change your attitude, you'll change your longitude. Right now, we're too low. And because we're too low, we allow the things that we see to affect us. It's time now to go higher. We got to go higher if you want to see the Lord. David said, in the midst of all that he was going on, it was going on with him, David said, I will lift my eyes into the hills from which cometh my help. From whence cometh my help? From whence cometh my help? Where is my help coming from? My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. Why? Because he will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall never slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth and even forevermore. By this I know that God has favored me. He did not allow my enemies to triumph over me. And somebody needs to say, I know that's right. Everyone standing.
Praise the Lord. This is Bishop Dwayne Castro, the senior pastor of the Universal Love, Peace, and Joy Church of God. I thank you for taking the time to listen to the word of this message, and we pray that the message will touch your heart and will be able to bless your life. It will be a wonderful thing to hear from you. When you have an opportunity, please reach out to me by calling 718-566-7950 or drop me an email at ulpj7@aol.com. Once again, that'll be ulpj7@aol.com. Until that time, may the Lord continue to richly bless you and everyone connected to you. Please know we're praying God's deliverance.